Hey guys, welcome back to Mogul Monday. Today we'll talk about EA Sports, hated by true gamers. Let's head into it. Electronic Arts is a leading publisher of video and computer games software in the world. Sega, Nintendo, and Atari manufacture video game players but only produce games for their own equipment. Electronic Arts, on the other hand, specializes in producing software for various manufacturers' hardware, whether computers, video game consoles, or CD-ROM players. Between 1989 and 1994, EA's earnings increased by 60% annually, indicating rapid growth in a rapidly expanding global market. Electronic Arts was founded in 1982 by three former Apple computer executives, William M. Tripp Hawkins III, a marketing director at Apple who became CEO at the age of 26, William Bingham, Bing, Gordon, the company's director of marketing. Hawkins and Gordon both graduated from Stanford University with an MBA. At a dinner with four of their friends at Hawkins' house, the decision was made to form a company that specialized in developing and marketing software games for home computers. EA began with an 11-person team and $5 million in funding from private investors. From the start, EA was adaptable, creating software for whatever computer hardware was popular at the time, and then even producing multiple versions of the same program to run on different systems. EA's first product, a software game for the Atari 800 game player, was released on May 1983, but the market quickly shifted to the Commodore system. EA quickly adjusted and released six more games for the Commodore 64 computer in October 1983. By betting on an unreleased Sega game player, EA made a significant entry into the video game market. For Sega's Game Genesis machine, which was the first 16-bit video game player available in the United States in 1989, EA did not simply revise, but created entirely new games. The 16-bit player was nearly twice as fast as the 8-bit machines at the time. EA worked on 8 to 10 projects for the Genesis player, each costing around $250,000 for a product development investment of $2 million to $2.5 million. The first games for Sega's Genesis were released in June 1990, but sales of the machine did not take off until 1991. Despite this, Genesis games accounted for a quarter of EA's 1990 sales. The Genesis's success was added in part by the enormous popularity of EA Sports games. EA was soon producing about 35% of the games for Sega's Genesis, giving them a head start on the software competition when it comes to developing games for 16-bit machines. Anyways, they were listed as the top hated company 2 years in a row. During EA's period of rapid growth in the early 2000s, the company developed a reputation for acquiring development studios primarily for their intellectual property assets rather than their talent, and then forcing changes on the studio's work product that impacted the quality or scope of the game, or determining the studios were no longer necessary due to this, gave the impression that EA was treating games like an assembly line, rushing to get as much product out as quickly as possible without regard for the content or creative team behind the games. As a result, the company earned the moniker Evil Empire within the video game industry. The way EA handled Origin Systems is a prime example of this business practice. Origin was purchased by EA in 1992. Despite the studio founder Richard Garriott's protests, EA pressured Origin to finish two Ultima games, Ultima 8, Pagan, and Ultima 9, Ascension. In comparison to the previous installments in the series, both titles received poor reviews. In addition to these, Origin had created the successful Ultima Online. The studio had begun work on Ultima Online 2 following the development of Ultima 9, but due to poor sales of Ultima 9, EA canceled the project, leaving Origin primarily to support Ultima Online until EA decided to close the studio in 2004. 2004, moving the remaining staff to other divisions within EA, Bullfrog Productions, Westward Studios, Maxis, and Pandemic Studios are among the studios thought to have been impacted by EA's handling. By 2008, EA had begun to change its ways, partly as a result of the appointment of a new CEO, John Riccitiello. Riccitiello admitted in 2008 that the company's previous acquisition practices were incorrect, and that the company now gives acquired studios more autonomy without interfering with their corporate culture. In a statement in 2014, the company's CFO Blake Yeagerson acknowledged that this previous practice was somewhat marginal in performance, and that going forward, the company would likely slow down on acquisitions, giving internal studios the opportunity to help produce major titles instead. Those who had worked in EA in the past and present echoed this statement. When ID Software's John D. Carmack announced that EA would publish their upcoming game Rage in 2008, he said EA was no longer the evil empire, according to Carmack. I'll admit that years ago, if you asked me, I still believed EA was the evil empire, the company that suffocates small studios. If you told me a year ago that we end up with EA as a publisher, I'd have laughed. When we went out and spoke with people, particularly EA partners like Valve, we received almost universally positive responses. In a 2014 interview, Peter Molyneux, the founder of Bullfrog, said that EA was not an evil empire, but acknowledged that when studios are acquired by companies like EA, the additional funds and support changing the flavor of the company and can lead to events that cause the studio to perform poorly. While EA's reputation for managing studios had improved since 2008, Engadget saw Visceral Games' closure in 2017 as a return to the company's bad habit of shuttering well-known studios. The publisher of Electronic Arts has been chastised for promoting FIFA's in-game purchases in a children's toy catalog. According to VGC, the publication in question is Smith's Toys' latest in-store magazine, which features an advertisement for FIFA 21 centered on the Ultimate Team mode. The second step of playing Ultimate Team was use FIFA points to open packs. FIFA points are a virtual currency that Electronic Arts sells exclusively for the Ultimate Team mode, with player packs serving as the sports series version of randomized loot boxes, or, as EA prefers to call them, surprise mechanics. The in-store placement also promoted the use of FIFA points and specifically advertised PlayStation Plus wallet top-ups. With EA being accused of unethically normalizing in-game purchases for kids, it has also fueled the debate over whether or not FIFA Ultimate Team is gambling. A class action lawsuit has been filed against the publisher in California, alleging that Ultimate Team violates the state's gambling laws. EA Sports added in-game ads for The Boys, an Amazon series, to UFC 4 about a month after it was released.
What the f***?
The ad had predominantly displayed in replay scenes, right in the center of the screen. On Reddit, enraged fans brought the issue to the attention of a larger audience, resulting in a company protest that forced EA to respond. EA appears to be paying attention to the criticism these days and attempting to change their ways in order to become a better company. What do you think about EA Sports? Do you play their games? Let us know in the comments section. This brings us to the end of our video. I hope you enjoyed it. Hit like if you didn't. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss any of our videos in the future. Also, watch the two videos that are on your screen because I'm sure you'll love them. With that, I'll see you in the next video.